Hi guys, I'm back today with yet another video, and today's video is a DIY. It's an exciting, fun project and I really hope you will enjoy it. If you're new around here, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Also, hit the bell icon to get notifications on any new videos. Also, if you're not following me on Instagram yet, don't forget to follow me on Instagram. I do keep updating and putting fun posts for you, so don't miss out on that. So for today's video, we will be making a fairy garden. And when I think about it, the very first video that I put on this channel was a fairy garden. If you haven't seen that yet, I will leave the link for you in the description down below. Now today's fairy garden is a themed fairy garden, especially because recently the theatres were showing a movie called The Lion King. And I'm sure everyone in their 30s relate to this movie very differently because it was a movie from our childhood. And then this brilliant idea struck us that let's make a fairy garden of the Lion King theme. And when I sat down to make it, I looked online for Simba, Pumbaa, Timon figurines and I just couldn't find any. So the next thing I had to do was try my hand at polymer clay. Now this is the first time that I've worked with polymer clay. And I really liked working with it. It was fun and it was quite a good experience. So I have tried to make Simba, Pumbaa and Timon, these characters from Lion King, in polymer clay, and I've tried my best. I'm no great artist, so whatever it is here. And to get these characters in the likeness, in the real likeness of the real characters, is extremely difficult. But then somehow I managed something. So as you can see, these tiny little bugs were made by my little Nathan. He came and he told me, "Mama, can you please let me use this in your fairy garden?" And I had to say yes. And I think the good part about making fairy gardens is involving your family, getting your children to do it along with you. So let me quickly introduce you to these guys. This one is Pumbaa, this one is Simba, and he is Timon. So our fairy garden is inspired by this scene right here. It's when the Hakuna Matata song is going on and Timon and Pumbaa are convincing Simba to eat bugs. That is why he has this shell-shocked expression on his face. He's wondering how he's going to eat these bugs. So I'll quickly run through the things that we will need to make this fairy garden. Obviously, first we will need the figurines. You set a theme and then you can either make your own figurines or you can buy them online. And it's up to you. The next thing you will need is rocks. Rocks are amazing fillers whenever you are doing your fairy garden and by the end of it you have finished up but you don't have enough plants to fill up certain small spots. You can always fill it up with rocks. It gives a complete fill. It just ties the whole fairy garden together. So I have an assortment of rocks here. Many of them I have picked up over time if I find something lying here and there, and some of them I have bought from the market. Like these ones are the artificial polished ones that I've bought from the market, these two and even these ones here. I usually pick up rocks that are very interesting, so do that and you can always use them in your fairy gardens. You can also use them to decorate pots, and also rocks are good accessories for your garden. The next thing I have here are pieces of driftwood. Now driftwood is something that you can pick up when you go for your trips or when you go out foraging. Driftwood is special because it usually is found floating in rivers and it is found on river banks, and this wood doesn't disintegrate when it is submerged in water, and this is specially used in fish tanks. So if you can't get them when you're out foraging, you can always look for them in aquarium shops. You can buy them from there. Now as you can see, these ones are cut and they are not natural, that are not ones that I've picked up from the ground. I had bought them when I had visited Kerala. It was from a small little wood shop. That is when I picked these up. This is how I'm going to use this one. I have drilled a little hole here, and if you had noticed that Timon was just half, his legs aren't there. So I intend to put Timon like this in the log, popping out. This is one piece of driftwood that I wanted to use. I wanted to make it look a little bit like a tree, not a very full tree, but a scraggly tree. So this I have achieved with making tiny little three kokedamas and gluing them onto the stumps of this tree. You can see the kokedamas are right here. And the plant that I've used is the Bolivian Jew. This plant grows under difficult circumstances as well. So it is a good and hardy plant to use. Now, making this kokedama tree is a separate project in itself. I have made another video for this and I will in the future post that video. I'll leave the link for you in the description box down below. Now, the next thing you can use is moss. Moss is completely optional because they're very difficult to keep alive, especially if you're not living in a humid and wet place. Now, because it's the monsoons going on, there was a little moss growing at the bottom of my pot. I didn't go foraging for it. I didn't have the time to. So I just picked the moss that was growing there. So it's not as healthy and not as green as I would want it to be, but I'm using it nevertheless. Now, I know that I might not be able to keep this moss alive because it needs a lot of care, a lot of wetness, a lot of moisture and good sunlight, and it needs the right conditions to thrive. So I'm using it now, but I may remove it later from my fairy garden. The next thing we need is a wide mouth pot. Okay, now your pot doesn't have to be high. It has to be wide. It can be shallow. Now the plants that usually go in fairy gardens are tinier plants that don't have a very deep and wide root system. So a shallow pot should be enough. The next thing we need is soil, a good well-draining soil. Now the thing is, I haven't used any perlite in this or anything that will change the color of the soil or make it white or look unnatural. What I have done is I've just simply used compost, coco peat and clay soil. And I mainly kept the color of the soil brown because I might expose some areas in the fairy garden and I would want it to look like the ground and not like some unnatural surface. And last but not the least, and definitely the most important thing that you will need, are plants. Now I have selected a variety of plants. I will not name them. I will put up the names on the screen to save time. These plants are all moisture loving plants, they're humidity loving plants, and they more or less will work well together. So that's how I've chosen these plants. Some of them are entire plants from my garden and some of them are simply cuttings, like plants that I use as ground cover, pot cover at the base of my main plant. To save your money, you can always use cuttings. So now that we have all the things that we need, let's start building the fairy garden. I'm going to quickly pat down the soil because the terrain that I'm going for is a flat terrain. Now I have this plate in my hand for one reason. I'm going to keep these things and see how my fairy garden will ultimately look like. And I will know exactly how much space I have to plant my plants. So this is where the characters will go. I'm just going to keep them. Something like this. And an assortment of bugs here and there. So now the place that I have to plant is over here. So now I'll leave this here just so that I know that I don't have to cross a particular boundary. The reason that I've not filled this pot up with soil is because I will first plant the plants, then I intend to bring the soil to a higher level. Let me start with the kokedama tree. I've just pushed it a little inside. Now I will put a little bit of soil here, behind it especially. So I will use stones to prop this tree up, otherwise it's definitely going to fall. Let's start with this bamboo. So I think I will place this right next to it to give it a more natural feel. This one is the Hemigraphis alternata, and I'm just going to prune its leaves down here, the big ones. So we will just give the roots a slight trim. Okay. One thing I do is I keep adding soil as I go to keep increasing the level of the soil. We will plant the Aralia right next to this one. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a break, remove the plate and bring the soil up. This is somewhere where I want the level of the soil to be. There's a lot of coco peat and the soil is springy. So I need to press it down so that there aren't any air gaps down, and when I water it will just not sink down. So now we're going to go for the plants that will be towards the edges here. I'm going to take this one now. next I will be putting the hypostyles, and I think I'll have to trim the roots. They're really very long. It's like you're giving a haircut. Don't worry, this doesn't do any damage to the plant. You can always choose plants that have good color in their foliage to add more interest and beauty to your fairy gardens. Now I picked most of these plants from a cart and I got it for pretty cheap. I feel it's already looking pretty, but I need to add more plants. Now here, I noticed one thing is that this plant, I have planted it the better side on the back and I think it's too squished in, so I'm just going to remove it and bring it a little in front. Okay, now since I have done this, you can see that the space has opened up. Both the Aurelia, the red ivy and the bamboo have just spread out. They look like they are happier already. Now this I think is the Tradescantia species. I'm not so sure the leaves, the way the leaves look and the way the stalk goes. But this plant is a very good plant. It is a good ground cover and it tends to fill up pots very well. I'm going to line him up in the side here. Now this one is a Pilia Creeping Charlie. I'm going to use him here and there. This is also extremely easy to propagate. These are cuttings from my balcony. Now I've used the Bolivian Jew on the Kokedamas here. They grow freely. They fill up pots. They are a little invasive. So I have to just be careful to trim it back. I'm just going to put like a bunch. I've bunched some of them together here. So I've got some hot glue here. I'm just going to poke this little fellow right in and this is how he will look. So now I have Timon ready in here. I'll let him dry out right there. So I think this area looks a little blank gap, like there's a hole here. So I'm going to put one Fittonia right here. And just in front of the Bolivian Jew right here. I just love how the nerve plant looks. I think I'm going to get the Bolivian Jew out. It's always good to change your plans. They don't always work out. I don't like the way this is looking here. I'm going to get it off. What I will do is I will flatten this out properly. But before I flatten it out, I'm going to just water this, the back of this, wet it a little bit, and then we're going to place the remaining characters. So now when I'm watering, I have to be very careful. I will water the base of the plants, not the leaves. And I can see the soil just sinking. So now it's time for my first thing to go in, that is my log with Timon. Now I'm going for this look because it is a jungle scene. I want it to be as dense and as filled up as possible. So now it's time to lay down the moss. I don't know how I'm going to do it because it's all a little gloopy and messy. But let's see. What I will try to do is I will try to forage for some more moss and add it to this later on probably. Try different types of stuff. I'm just popping one in Pumbaa's mouth. I left his mouth open, so I popped one in his mouth. I'm also using what Nathan made, so that you know he really has fun looking at all these things. That scene in the Lion King movie, the bugs were just bursting. That's why I made enough and more bugs. I feel like putting all of them, but I think it's looking a little over. I need to stop somewhere. Looks colorful, nice. It looks like a scene from the movie. It's given me a lot of joy and I really really enjoyed doing this. One thing I want to tell you is that each of these figurines have been made by me, and I know they're not perfect, but it's okay. You don't have to be perfect. It's the fun, it's the enjoyment of making it, of doing everything by hand, and then of knowing that oh wow, I created something like this. So that's really nice.
Oh,
Now I'm done. This fairy garden is ready, and you can see that the smile is not going off my face. I can't stop smiling. So I'm going to control myself a little, and now I'm going to mist this garden. I feel a little moistness. Looks good, because what I was aiming for is a forest scene, and usually forests are moist and dark and full of plants. So that is the look that I was going for, and I think to a certain extent I have achieved it, and I'm really happy with what I've got here. I'm avoiding misting the front side, but it won't affect my figurines because I have given them proper coats of varnish, and I don't think it will affect the colors of my figurines at all. But I'm trying to keep the front side dry and the plants and the log a bit moist, so that it looks like a jungle, like the inside of a jungle. So now there are two upcoming videos connected to this project. One is the Kokedama tree. I will show you in that video how to make a Kokedama tree. Once I upload those videos, I will leave the links down below in the description box. The second video is how I made the polymer clay figurines. I would also really like to thank John and Sharvari from Curls and Beards for letting me use their music in this video. They are excellent, talented musicians. Please go and check out their channel. It's worth checking out. I will leave the link for that in the description down below. Guys, you know how much I love to read your comments. Please leave some comments down below letting us know if you like this project or not, or if you're going to try something like this, or if you've already tried something like this. Do let us know. So I will see you next time. Till then, stay green.